The disparity between the number of people waiting for an organ and the number of organs available is significant. About 20 people every day are dying on the wait list.
Last year, we had the most organ donors from deceased donation that we've ever had, compared to 20 years ago. Deceased organs now come from donors who are older, who have more comorbidities or other diseases.
One of the things that routinely comes up is how devastating it is to throw an organ away that potentially could have been transplantable, but because you didn't have enough information, you didn't have enough time, you just didn't feel like you could do it safely.
If any organs could be rehabilitated and made acceptable for use for transplant, we could rescue those patients.
What we're doing in our lab is taking livers and kidneys and putting them onto a machine to study those organs to find out where the different issues are that might be impairing their function over time.
In particular, we're really focused on taking these organs that are being discarded because we're not sure that there'll be a good outcome or statistics suggest that that may be a more dangerous organ, and developing new therapeutic and diagnostic innovations that would allow us to take that organ and repair it.
To have an opportunity to actually study the exact organs that we're hoping to rescue and to study therapies on those organs is so important.
What it allows us to do is sort of look inside the organ in real time and in a way kind of put the organ on a treadmill and see, does it have fitness, can it work? We can also do things like label our drugs with a nuclear tracer and see, does it get everywhere where we need it to go? And if it doesn't, well, what about after we deliver this therapeutic? Now has it gotten to where we need it to be?
Using this kind of translational research is really transformational because it allows us to look independently at organs, human organs, that we've never been able to do before.
Even if some of these organs are declined or discarded for transplantation, we have the ability to utilize some of these organs to perform research that may end up being a gift that could help so many more people in the future.
I'm incredibly passionate about how we honor the gift that a donor family chooses to make. And if it can't go to a single recipient, it's our responsibility to figure out how to have that still have a major impact on the lives of potential recipients.
The stakes are very high for our patients. They are living on the edge of life and death every day. And so knowing that the research you're doing has this ability to save lives, not 50 years from now, but tomorrow. It's so rewarding, and I can't think of anything else I'd rather do.